Bitcoin is not crypto, why Ripple might not be out of the woods yet, and a mega DeFi hack happening this week in the crypto market talk. In this week's episode, we will first jump into some news and then we will have a look onto the charts of specifically Bitcoin and Ethereum. Let's get started with, I would say, more positive news first. Bitcoin is not crypto. The SEC seems to confirm that, according at least to an interview or to a statement that the Coinbase CEO Brian Armstrong gave this week. He was saying that the SEC approached Coinbase in regards to delisting specific cryptocurrencies or specific assets that they have on the platform, except Bitcoin. The exact wording is this: they came back to us and they said, we believe every asset other than Bitcoin is a security. And we said, well, how are you coming to that conclusion? Because that's not our interpretation of the law. And they said, we're not going to explain it to you. You need to delist every asset other than Bitcoin. While this statement carries kind of different implications, on one side, of course, how can a cryptocurrency exchange exist with other assets missing besides Bitcoin? And on the other side, why is Bitcoin not a security? What is the plan there? And what is the standing also for Ethereum? Now, we've had the news of Ripple, for example, specifically being labeled not a security. Of course, this statement comes from a couple of weeks ago, so this could essentially also mean that the SEC's standing has changed. Now, on one side, of course, we've had the positive news regarding the Ripple case, and we assumed that a lot of the other altcoins will also not be labeled as securities by the SEC. However, there is some interesting movement happening here, because here the headline says, judge rejects motion to dismiss Terraform case, disagrees with Ripple decision. Now, specifically, Judge Jed Rakoff is saying here that the case against Terraform Labs is still going to continue, and the decision against Ripple, or for Ripple in this case, is going to be ignored. Now, if we rewind back a bit more than a year ago, we've had the situation of Terraform Labs and the Terra Luna token, as well as their UST stablecoin, the Mirror protocol, the Anchor protocol, kind of this Terra Luna ecosystem. It completely imploded, of course, and with that, the SEC alleged that they are orchestrating a multi-billion dollar crypto asset securities fraud. Now, because of the Ripple decision, essentially Terraform Labs has appealed to the judge and has said, well, Ripple is also not a security, we're also not a security, but the judge has decided against that. John Reed Stark here on Twitter is essentially looking into this case specifically from the outside and is saying that it does very much look like it will also get an appeal on Ripple's case as well. So the SEC will appeal the Ripple case and will argue that Ripple is still a security. So there is some trouble in the crypto markets, at least for now. The trouble unfortunately continues, because we've seen this week also attackers stealing more than 40 million. When this news article came out, it was just 24 million. It's currently up to 40 million plus in several DeFi protocols, and so 40 million US dollars have been stolen from several DeFi protocols because of a curve pool exploit. Specifically, the LETH, the MSETH, and the PETH pools have been attacked here in a so-called relock attack or re-entrancy lock attack, and that has caused a lot of different DeFi protocols to also ring the alarm. Now, in the meantime, of course, one of these problems have been solved, but at the same time, of course, the effects or the ripple effects of that are still to be felt. Now, the big question, of course, is what is that going to do with Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies? We will jump into the charts in just a second, but first let's discuss this currently. We have, of course, a bit of positive news, a bit of negative news. Positive is still, of course, the ETF discussion here. We can see here, for example, the head of ecosystem growth at Optimism has said that the first gold ETF launched in 2003 catalyzed a 350% surge in gold prices within 7 years. This could provide a useful analog for potential Bitcoin price trajectory. So this is kind of the positive side, but the other side, of course, is this entire chaos of the Curve token, because while the Curve token is collapsing, we're seeing here also that the position of the company's founder, who pledged Curve, so CRV tokens, to buy Tether, so USDT, is here in the situation that where the pressure is being mounted onto the Curve token once again. The founder of Curve has in the meantime used a couple of million, I think it's even in the three-digit million range, has used that money to buy up a house, and the Curve tokens currently are heavily under pressure. Now, what does that do with the Bitcoin price? Of course, I've mentioned here that we've touched this area of 28,000, around 800, so 28.8, and currently we are going for a retouch. I do think this could break, actually. So while it currently looks like it is just going for a retouch, I do think a bit of bad news around this Curve drama, and I think Bitcoin could drop here even further. So for now, very interestingly, I'm looking at this right here. So 25 and 26.4 would be my next re-entry points for the Bitcoin price. And next up, we can also talk about Ethereum. While Ethereum is still holding up very nicely, and don't forget, this whole DeFi drama is ultimately also playing onto Ethereum, because Ethereum is, of course, the base layer here. We can see here that while the trend is still in play, I do think that this could actually be broken up fairly soon. So again, have a quick look at this trend line here and do expect the Ethereum price to correct on the road as well. So for now, still in the summer drama of cryptocurrencies, I do expect a bit more lower prices, and ideally towards autumn and then winter, we will see higher prices. That was it from the Crypto Market Talk this week. Make sure that you're subscribed to not miss any other crypto news. I'll see you on the next one. Have a good one. We'll be right back.